And now for something completely different.
I finally get to play one of my favorite heroes. It's Obi-Wan Kenobi. It pretty much the opposite, but you know, same principle. So I mean, once again, all the Jedi are kind of the same. They're sort of copy and paste, so there's not really much you can do. He's obviously a defensive guy, so you have to get really like up close and personal in order to get to him. He's very good at deflecting shit. What else is he? Oh yeah, he does a little like swirly deflecting blaster bolt thing if you do his dash. It can deflect blaster bolts coming right at him. At least whenever I play, that's what happens to me. I don't know if that's actually supposed to be in the game. But it seems like a very Obi-Wan thing. He's got his saber. He can throw it for a long range shit.
Woo!
I don't like Maul, he's scary. But it does do damage if you hit people. As an attack should. I got Anakin.
You are the chosen one!
His force push is actually really good. Yeah, it can do a lot of... Ow. It can do a lot of good stuff. It's very wide. And can throw a lot of enemies around. That's the one that I use the most. Or the ability that I use the most in this game. Just because it can knock people down and then you can just jump on them and capitalize. It's also anti-air. So, like, say we got this Jango over here being a dick. Don't worry about it because I can handle it. Much like all lightsaber throws, crowd control, be thy way. There we go. Ow. His jump attack is also like if you're getting caught. Once again, completely like counterattack sort of thing, but it's a very good wide little strike as you come down, so. You thought. Alright, well, that didn't go quite my favor. Get your ass out of here, Anakin. Yeah! Yeah. He's basically just a defensive guy, but he's really good. There is a little trick that for force users, though. You can still use your super speed and save your energy. I didn't show this off with Vader, because when he flies around, you're gonna need the speed, especially since he walks faster. But there's the normal force sprint. If you have force push equipped, you can press the block button. You'll still go pretty fast in like a slow motion thing, and it doesn't cost an ounce of your stamina. So it still acts like you're in the sprint, and you can still move pretty fast, and best of all, you can still do the dash attack out of it. Yeah, it's a good thing. Once again, I don't know if it's a glitch or if it's meant to be in here, but it works. Ah! Oh, I shouldn't just stand there, that's bad. Where is he at? Fortunately, Jedi training has nothing to do with saving yourself from being set on fire. This hurts. But overall, he's actually one of the people that I play the most, just because he's fun and the tactics you can do with him are actually really good. Plus, he's the world's sexiest Jedi, so. Well, sexiest Jedi, you see, because it's different. I got electrocuted. Emperor killed me from behind. It's rude. Plus, they actually have a James Arnold Taylor doing the voice as as usual. So that's good. I love me some JAT, and he does a very good job. I believe you only get to play as him in one level though, which doesn't make much sense in the lore, because in the campaign, he only shows up in the Battle of Utapau, but the 501st wasn't there. It'd be the 212th, which was Obi-Wan's division with Cody. The 501st wouldn't have been there, they would have been with Anakin. But I digress. That's fine. I still got to play as Obi-Wan, fight Grievous. Honestly, like, any Fett or flying character in this game stands no chance again. Oh my god in heaven. Listen, scary.
You strike me down now, become more powerful than you could ever possibly imagine.
Okay, I got him. So, you know, you start flying around with that jetpack, it's not gonna do anything for you. I do too. I'll fucking do it again. I don't care. They should know lightning doesn't work on Kenobi. Yup, nup. Yup, nup. I don't know why that just gotcha so much, but I find it hilarious that it did. Yeah, but you were talking about that for like days afterward. It was stupid. Yeah, I know what the I do. That's... Yes. Yes, I know. Dear God. Yup, nup. Wabba-doo-doo-ba-dup. Yup, nup. Wabba-doo-doo-ba-dup. Because you're giggling about it like a pothead. Woohoo! And then I'm over here just singing a music. Singing a music. Sure, whatever you want to believe, but. I feel good. Though this map doesn't really have any, if you're playing on a map that, like there's like poop areas, Kenobi would be perfect for like the Elios well. Just cause his force push is that good. Get your hands off your daughter, Anakin! Hey, that ended just like how it does in the movie. I was fighting Anakin and he jumped. He tried it and I just as I threw the saber, he got fucked up. Yeah, for some reason you can never block saber attacks with a saber in this game. Makes no goddamn sense. I don't know. But that's how it is. And that's okay, it's whatever. There's ways around it. Alright, who wants to come? Oh my god. Who wants to come at me? Everybody does. Okay, that's one. Get your flying ass down here. That's what I thought. aggressive Obi-Wan. Basically, you playing EA's Battlefront. Not the way you're supposed to play him in the slightest, but that's just how it is. Also, I do like Obi-Wan's jump, because if someone throws their saber at you, you can do a backflip over it, and woohoo, and not get hit if you can do it right. But then, you know, if you're playing against a smart person, you can just push them out of the air, and then wait for your saber to come back and punish them. So it's not foolproof, but sometimes. Alright, I hear Vader's music. That is never a good sign, ever. Look at this tanky fucking Emperor. I've never heard someone say, "Look at the Emperor he's carrying." Alright, Maul. That's what you thought. No, I win the game. I win. You fools. But... Oh, Jango! Okay, I can do this. Jango is basically Boba, but better. Just like he is in the movies. No. It's because of what he does before he dies. Anyways, in this game, he's really good. Poor Chewbacca, he got fucked up. He of course has the jetpack, which is his strongest attribute. His maneuverability is pretty much unmatched, even by Jedi characters. But once again, one smart Jedi with force powers, it spells bad news for you. If you're a good player, you can shoot from the air. I'm not the best at it, but I don't need it because, you know, I have devices such as combat rolling and flying away. He's not tanky though. He can die pretty fast, as you would expect. His main weapon, his little West Star pew pew pistol, is a super strong projectile weapon. So strong that it can actually function as like a semi-automatic sniper. That's why I have, as you can see, there's the little scope on there. It has a very nice long range. Makes me a happy boy. Especially with his mobility, with the whole jetpack situation. You can go to a vantage point that other people can't reach you at, and just easily. You can very easily just snipe people all day. That's typically how I play. Oh no! Okay, well, Ahsoka killed me. I could've. As for secondary weapons, he has a flamethrower. The flamethrower in this game is nothing to be desired. If you can use your pistol at all times, use that, because that's just a better weapon. The flamethrower is kind of good for crowds, but as far as damage output, no reason at all to use it. Or if you're low on ammo with your pistol, because once again, for some freaking reason, motherfucking Windu, he just came out of nowhere and blew up my medical droid. That's just scary. There's two of them. That felt good. I'm happy now. It's just, there's no reason for it. He does have wrist rockets. Wrist rockets are really good. More so against, like, infantry and stuff than meagles, for some reason. Also, explain this to me, because this doesn't make any damn sense. How can you block fire? Like, with a lightsaber. The Force I can understand, but a lightsaber doesn't block fire. It doesn't block flame. Why do you do this? In EA's Battlefront, Boba's melee, which is his flamethrower. I think it's really weird that they made it like that, but you know, I'm not complaining. Just gotta get used to it. It goes through blocks. You can assign weapons, or assign commands, so. Yeah, and just like any blaster character in Heroes versus Villains, if someone jumps at you, your gun is the perfect weapon for it, because you can shoot them out of the air really quickly. Especially with Jango's firing speed. That was nasty, and I love it. I'm pretty sure Jango can take fall damage as well, but just before you hit the ground, just pop the jetpack a little bit. You can stop yourself in midair and then have an easy descent. But yeah, his wrist rockets are good. His other grenade-style weapon is a time bomb, which isn't... As I've said before, the time bomb isn't that good unless you're doing a mission where you have to, like, blow up an object. But you can sometimes set it as a trap, where, like, if someone's chasing after you... See if I can do it. You can sort of dance on them, keep them around that bomb. Boom. Kieri Mundi, dead. There goes him. Jump over Yoda. So it's not like Jango's useless. He actually can go hard quite a bit. I don't know why Maul scared me, but he did. Obi-Wan! And much like any other blaster character, he can combat roll and dodge around and sprint and all that. So if you run out of jetpack, you can still sprint away and not be completely doomed.
Today's next.
Let's use the flamethrower on them. Okay, so she got me before I could kill her, but flamethrower did its job in the end. So yeah, if you're close to death, the flamethrower can be a good idea too, because especially after a fight with how much damage you can do with an experienced Jango. The flamethrower can handle the rest of it. Are you okay? Did you die? Don't do that. Don't do that. You can and you will. You can, you will, you won't stop. All the way up into the end of the original trilogy. Because technically the last mission in the campaign is the Battle of Hoth, but you can tell that like Rex knows that the events of Endor and the Return. You blow up my droid, I blow you up. But yeah, it's Jango. Honestly, I prefer I j- just like I do in the movies, I prefer Jango more than Boba. A shitload of people under me. Hopefully there aren't like any stairs. Okay, I can drop it there. Will that kill him? Whoa, okay. That's kind of broken, but I love it. That's just beautiful all the way around. We're about to. So, with my playstyle, I like to. I like to go up on buildings, as you know. Yoda, fuck off. I like to go up on buildings and snipe. If there's a bunch of people underneath you, what you can do is, you can use your time. Oh, shit. Thank God there aren't melee. Oh, fuck. Fuck off, Yoda. Yoda! No! Grandmaster Fuckface, go away. Anyways, if you're up on a sniping building, and a bunch of people are below you, shit, you can take your time bomb, toss it over the side of the building onto the ground below that you, where all the enemies are standing, and wait, keep sniping, the bomb will explode and kill a bunch of people. I just did that. So 66 kills, 4 deaths. That's pretty good.